Man City beat, got beaten again today, 2-0. Shocking.
Thomas Rhodes' dad, and over the last 22 years, obviously, I've been Thomas's father, and myself and my wife have brought him up to the best of our ability. When my wife and me found out that Thomas was deaf, profoundly deaf, I suppose the reaction was one of shock. There was a bit where he passed all his initial hearing tests, partly because he has such a good visual awareness around him. And so eventually it did dawn on us, myself and my wife, that he wasn't hearing as you would expect him to hear. He was missing things. If you called him, he wouldn't turn and things like that. So we did take him for a hearing checkup, an official one. And by that point, he was 18 months. It was a shock to be told that your son is profoundly deaf. It's not something like glue ear, it was much more serious than that, and in both ears. So Thomas has a cochlear implant, and we went down that pathway because the hearing aids, the digital hearing aids that he was using, I mean, you've got to remember it was over 20 years ago now, but the digital hearing aids were having no impact, and obviously with profound hearing loss, hearing aids are really not going to give him that much hearing. So we were in contact with different audiologists and speech and language therapists, and the Elizabeth Foundation down near Portsmouth, which was one of its kind really in the country. And they recommended that Thomas should go down an oral route with a cochlear implant. And after a lot of thinking about it and the impact of the operation and what that would mean for Thomas and the long-term consequences of that, we decided to go for a cochlear implant because we felt that, yes, he was always going to be part of the deaf community, but we wanted to have the option for him of being part of the hearing world and to be able to access what everybody else could access. And then as he got older, it was his choice. He could either choose to sign or he could choose the oral route, or do both, and that was really what guided our thinking. So it was a difficult decision, but we made it in good faith, and we've never regretted it, never looked back with that decision. I think it was the right one.
You're not working till Friday?